Hi, I'm Mitchell, one of the product owners here at Plugable. Today, we're going to be talking about the 2023 MacBook Pros, specifically the 14-inch M2 Pro and the 16-inch M2 Max versions. Since release day, our team in Redmond, Washington has been doing a lot of compatibility testing to see how well these new systems work with our products. If you want to check out our blog for more information on those compatibility test results, I'll leave a link in the description. From the M2's debut in 2022 to the release of the M2 Pro and M2 Max at the start of 2023, not a lot has changed on the outside. Inside, however, the new MacBook Pros offer a bevy of new specs and improvements. One of the biggest improvements, at least for me, is native support for more external displays without relying on a driver-based solution. The M2 Pro supports a total of 2 additional screens, while the M2 Max can support up to 4. But the max number of displays either model will support from a single Thunderbolt 4 port is 2. The original M1 and M2 MacBooks, you might recall, only have native support for one extended display. From our testing with these new laptops, we've chosen to highlight a couple of docking stations that really stand out for performance, flexibility, and the added functionality they provide. So let's take a look at 2 of our favorite docks for these laptops. And we'll start with our pick for the best docking station for the M2 Pro and M2 Max powered MacBook, the Plugable TBT4-UDZ. Launched at CES 2023, this Thunderbolt 4 docking station has 2 HDMI ports and 2 DisplayPort connections, so you can mix or match your screens. No matter which display connections you land on, both monitors can run at up to 4K 60 resolution, at the full native performance of the Apple Silicon. It's worth noting that technically this is a quad dock for Windows users. The underlying technology to make that work, called MST, isn't supported on Mac at this time, so on Mac systems, this is a dual display dock. But a more convenient connection for your screens is just the start. On the front of the dock, you have your SD card readers, 2 USB ports, an audio input-output combo jack, and a Thunderbolt 4 connection to the host with 98 watts of charging. On the back, you have even more room to grow with your 4 USB ports, a 10 gigabit per second USB-C port, 2.5 gig Ethernet, our first dock with 2.5 gig Ethernet, which I'm excited about, and your display connections. With 16 ports in total, you should be able to get your MacBook connected to, well, just about everything. Here's a common question we get. What's the difference between the TBT4-UDZ I just talked about and its predecessor, the TBT3-UDZ? The biggest shift is on Windows systems, where the newer Thunderbolt 4 design supports up to 4 displays. As I mentioned a minute ago, the underlying technology for that quad display support, MST, isn't currently available on Mac systems, so the display capabilities are relatively unchanged between versions. Additionally, the Thunderbolt 4 dock has 2.5 gig Ethernet compared to the 1 gig Ethernet on the Thunderbolt 3 version, so that's a big plus for those who want to make use of next-gen wired Ethernet capabilities. And then there's some low-level, subtle improvements in the Thunderbolt 4 version, like USB packet tunneling and an increased certified charging rate. If your use case doesn't see a strong benefit from those enhancements, consider the predecessor, the TBT3-UDZ. It has a similar complement of connections, but with a slightly lower charging at 96 watts. This model is a little cheaper too, which is always a nice feature. We've tested both of these docks extensively on the M2 Pro and M2 Max powered MacBook Pros, and they performed exceptionally. Thanks for learning more about docking Apple's latest MacBooks with me. If you'd like to get a better look at the products we talked about today, I'll leave links down below. And as always, if you have questions on connections or comments on anything else, you can let us know down below or contact us directly by emailing support@plugable.com. To get all the latest updates from Plugable, be sure to like and subscribe.